income have decreased in a 70% for people who are dedicated to promote the typical gastronomy of the island, delighting the palate of those who taste the sweets, breads, traditional porridge, among others. Nubia de Armas, owner of a Fear Table, as it is known in the island territory, tells us how the change has been.
We don't have the same circulation of the amount of people that used to circulate, and we don't have the same amount of people working. You don't have non-tourists. My business, well, it went down in the 70%. The income them that I used to receive, I'm not receiving it now because I had a posada nativa. The posada is not functioning because you don't have tourists. And well, the table, the fear table, is just the 30% it generates right now.
For Nubia, another woman who make a living from this activity, the current situation has been a challenge due to the low flow of people. Also, the schools of traditional dances and bands in the archipelago have been affected by the health emergency. Anthony Taylor, a musician, composer, a member of a well-known band in the island, and Dionisio Forbes Telesford, a dance teacher, are looking forward to return soon to work in what they like most.
Being that there is security that we have to be using to keep one distant and support, that is what I've sacralized. The process of continue teaching our dance to the younger set or the people that have interest, some interest to learn it. We know that our dance is more salon dance, European style dance, and one of the main thing is the contact, physical contact.
The big obstacle we got right now, Phil, that we can't play, and it's just like when you take away one plate thing for a child, you can't play, and right now, by the whole situation there, we can't play.
It is hoped that soon important actors of the culture on the island will be able to resume their activities.